a brand new book that chronicles a crime that horrified people in our city and really captured worldwide attention. The Devil's Cinema, the untold story behind Mark Twitchell's Kill Room, tells the story of the murder of Johnny Altinger and delves into the mind of his killer, Mark Twitchell. And author Steve Lillebuen is with us today, also a journalist and spent time working at the Edmonton Journal, which
That's right.
I guess led you into this story.
Yeah.
Perhaps remind people very briefly what this crime was all about.
Yeah, I mean, as a crime reporter, you come across lots of crazy, sinister stuff, but this definitely was, you know, off the charts. And to sum it up in a sentence, it's basically Mark Twitchell was a filmmaker, and he had made a movie script, and then that movie script turned into a real-life crime.
You had a lot of contact with Twitchell, mm-hmm. which resulted in this book. How did you get so close with him, for lack of a better explanation? You know what I mean? How did you connect and stay connected with him?
Sure. It was about a year of contact that we had while I was researching the book. And it started with a phone call from him, actually. Caught me totally off guard. I had been, you know, interviewing his friends and family and whoever. And a number had been passed on to him. And I get a call one day, and the voice on the other end just says, "Hey, it's Mark." Just like that, didn't even give a last name.
You met him in the remand center. What was that like? What did he have to say to you?
Yeah. So I went in, I was quite apprehensive. You know, I had my own preconceptions of what to expect and, you know, some sinister character kind of lurking into the room. But I was really struck by these other qualities he had that didn't come out in the media coverage. He's very charismatic. You know, I guess he used those qualities to deceive people through most of his life.
Does he admit to killing Johnny Altinger yet?
Not yet, no. Still to this day, even though he's been convicted, you know, guilty from a jury of his own peers, he still says that it was not first-degree murder, that this was self-defense.
SK Confessions was a file that was deleted on his computer that police found mm-hmm. that mirrored the events leading up to Johnny Altinger's death and to Jill Tetro escaping from Twitchell. And I ask you this, do you think that Twitchell actually acted out his own script?
I think for the most part, yes. I think there's a part of him that thought it was a brilliant cover, because if police ever questioned him, he had an excuse. That's not a murder weapon, that's just a movie prop. But he was damned by his own words, is because he had done that, he had left a complete trail of everything he had done. And all the police had to do was kind of go through a checklist of, can we prove this is true? And that's what they did with the SK Confessions document, is there's 301 things in there, and they proved that 85% of them were actually facts.
There have been more than one or two documentaries done on this, and mm-hmm. Media outlets in the States doing documentaries on this as well, what happened with Twitchell and Altinger and the killing. What does your book bring to this case that perhaps other coverage hasn't?
Sure. I think probably the two main things is, we still haven't heard a lot about Johnny Altinger. You know, he's the victim in this story, and a lot of who he was and how he lived his life before tragically losing it hasn't really been told. So I interviewed a lot of his friends and co-workers to get sort of flush out his details. And also it's the kind of inside the killer's mind. It's because of my year-long correspondence with Twitchell, I was able to really get into what makes this guy tick and kind of lay the groundwork of how we got to where we are today.
And did you struggle with this?
It, some parts, yes, because, you know, it's very dark material, and, you know, I also had to ask the credibility of who I was talking to. I mean, he was a convicted murderer. He's an admitted liar. So I had to do lots of research verifying everything he told me.
And very quickly, do you think that Twitchell is getting any pleasure from this notoriety, perhaps?
That's a theory, definitely the detectives thought, that and why he did all of this. But I don't think so, because when they did try to use the media to some degree upon his arrest to help him, you know, solve the case, he shied away from it. When cameras were put near him, he hid under his coat.
Okay. Well, the international launch of The Devil's Cinema is tonight at 7 p.m. at the Garneau Theater, presented by LitFest. We've got a link to more information on our website. Click onto news links. We also have two pairs of tickets to give away. Call 780-486-9233. or 1-877-486-2376 if you can attend tonight. Steve, thanks very much for coming in. I appreciate
thanks for having
your time
me.
And your thoughts on this.
Yeah, thank you.